group of Victoria Police has just finished making history as the first ever officers to wear their uniforms in Melbourne's Gay and Lesbian Pride March. Reporter Claire Brady joins me now from St Kilda, where the festivities are continuing.
A steamy day for the march, set to raise the temperature in St Kilda.
I think it's great that the police are here to show their support for the whole community, to celebrate the fact that we've got a very diverse Victoria.
About 50,000 joined in the 7th annual march. Organisers feel the Victoria Police presence is a sign of respect towards the gay community. Claire Brady, 7 News.
7 News.
The purpose of tonight is so that everyone can find out whether being a Melbourne marching girl and going to Mardi Gras 2002 is for them in terms of rehearsals, what's expected of everyone, etc.
What time span, you know.
Performing in Mardi Gras is really important to me. I love dancing and I love glitter and I love marching with other women and being okay to be me. It's about like freedom to just scream and holler and dance and really, really go for it like nowhere else, nowhere else.
Mardi Gras for me was an enormous confidence booster in terms of being able to be someone who could actually perform in front of a crowd of people. For Mardi Gras, there's 9 rehearsals of 2 hours. They're run over 3 weeks, 3 rehearsals a week. And there's also a full dress rehearsal after that.
The theme is, for this year, have a devilish good time. Melbourne marching girls, the cheerleaders from hell.
Bring it on, Liz.
I'm in. Well, I've paid up, so I'm in now.
I'm going to be a marching girl.
I hear it's fun.
So have you ever been to Mardi Gras?
No. I've seen her on TV.
Big adrenaline rush coming to you guys.
My girlfriend made me do it.
I've just signed up tonight with the Melbourne Marching Girls. I don't know quite what I'm in for. I'm not quite sure what to expect, but I'd love to go to Mardi Gras, and this seems like a great opportunity to go with a group of women.
I haven't done Mardi Gras yet. 6 years have been out and never even been up there, so I want to be there and I want to be there with lots of friends.
So I think it's gone pretty well. I'm quite pleased at the reaction, except for a few comments on the cones.
I'd already done Mardi Gras twice on the back of a motorbike and it was just fantastic. But what was really my self-expression about going to Mardi Gras, and that was I wanted to dance down Oxford Street wearing next to nothing. Vicki Jones put up her hand and Julie Munro, Vicki's partner, said she'd drive the truck. So that's where it started. I need to consider that people may not have done this before. So the challenge is to try and make a routine look fantastic with simple steps.
Caroline, good to see you.
Hi, Annalisa.
How was your break?
It was great, thanks.
Fantastic.
How was your summer?
Well, I met a girl.
Tell me more.
Well, we went to the beach together and we had the most amazing time, but, well, she had to go.
Every night before we start to reduce injury, okay? So if you can come over here and put yourselves in this space. Okay, first movement for tonight. So how it goes is this.
1, 2, 3, 4. Very good. Ready? I'll count you in. 4, 3, 2, go. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Okay, I'm really nervous doing this, but I'm Belle May Todd from Bragalong, which is a small country town in Gippsland, and I'm having a ball. I was involved in the Pride March and I thought that would be a good way of seeing how I adapted to the routines and seeing how I travelled, because it takes me 3 to 3.5 hours to travel from home down to rehearsals. Here I am, here, standing next to the Chief Commissioner of Police, and the adrenaline was just pumping. I was just so on a natural high. And now we're rehearsing for the Mardi Gras, and I reckon I'll probably pass out with the excitement of being in Sydney and actually marching there.
So it will go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, okay? And then...
What could be more fun than starting the year off with the Melbourne Marching Girls? Going to Mardi Gras, going to Sydney, doing the parade. I've never been to the Mardi Gras before. I was actually supposed to go to Sydney this year, but I met this girl.
I've got a bit of a dilemma, actually. There's this girl here, and we had this really romantic time together away over summer.
I was going to start my master's degree in women's studies, and then I think I met her again, and she still didn't return my call, so I feel like a real idiot now. I've thrown in this course to stay in Melbourne, to be with her, and she obviously couldn't give a shit.
And she didn't even tell me she was staying in Melbourne, and...
I'm just going to be cool. I'm just going to, if she doesn't want to talk to me, I'm not going to talk to her. I don't care.
She can join. I don't care.
No, I don't care.
Now, we have a dilemma. We have a gap up at the back. We need one more recruit.
Take a while, but I'm getting there. At the end of this, I'm going to be up high. Believe me.
Chicks want height.
Yeah?
Chicks want height.
Mm-hmm. Well, we actually are the bachelors.
Well, as you can see, we're the bachelors.
As you can see,
Mitch, yeah. And you've got Don.
The reason that we only perform for, Hot August Nights, is that we keep ourselves exclusive. Bachelor boys, ooh, sexy. Bachelor boys, ooh, yeah. Bachelor boys, oh, so sexy. Bachelor boys, ooh. Bachelor boys, ooh, ooh, sexy. Bachelor boys, ooh, yeah. Bachelor boys, oh, so sexy. Bachelor boys, ooh.
Hi, I'm Ainsley. I'm one of the co-conveners for Melbourne Marching Girls. I've been involved with the committee now for the last 2 years. I'm really excited to go to Mardi Gras again. This will be number 5 and the 4th one that I've been in. And it never wears off. Every time I get on Oxford Street, you still have that big adrenaline rush, and it's different every time. And there's always different tiers for different reasons at the end of the parade.
Make a costume with committee. One person has to work out the details and the planning of it. I'm lucky enough to be that person.
Where
tracing and cutting out patterns for the skirt, and they will end up looking like that. Pretty much what we're doing is A, B, C's and D's, and you'll be happy to know that most people are an average B.
I scored the pattern making job. So now I'm making up a 12, so Mary gets to have to explain what the new look looks like, the design's changed a bit. A 12 is a kind of a mock-up of the design. It's a French word.
It can't be done. You need the professionals to make a pom-pom.
We pay. We sell raffle tickets. That's all we can do. They're just too hard to make. I've got a list of 18 things for the girls to do today. There's only 68 of them to do.
I am Texas. Came out here all the way from San Francisco to help out the Melbourne Marching Girls. Very excited to be here.
That's tight, right? Yeah. You can make it and reach it on you.
I know, but then they've got to breathe.
Maybe they need a...
They've got to breathe.
Jeez, you want everything, don't you?
This will be my third time doing costumes for the Marching Girls. 2 years ago, I was in a very different place. I was married with a 10-year-old. And quite a few things happened that made me want to analyse my whole life, really, my sexuality, the whole lot. I think what keeps me going is there's a frantic 15 minutes or so before they're dressed, and then the music starts, they start marching, and it all happens, and I sort of stand back very proudly and think, that's my girls.
And this is going to be the pom-pom with some more gold in it. I've ordered them today from Queensland. It's light, but it's still full.
This will be my second Mardi Gras with the Melbourne Marching Girls, and I initially came along to accompany my girlfriend, who is a Melbourne Marching Girl, and got involved in some of the behind the scenes work that goes on. I'm on the technical committee, and the technical committee is responsible for all the work that goes on behind the scenes, the vehicles, the floats, the lights, sound, that kind of thing.
Even 2 weeks out, we get the utes, whatever we're using, the equipment, and basically set it up, power it up, run it for 8-10 hours.
Yep.
We know it works.
Pack it up.
Is it that Jules is driving the vehicle and pressing play? Are you in charge of Water Girls again?
Yeah, if you want me out.
You know, I'll go at the front and deal with the...
You'll be the
Mardi Gras marshal.
Yeah, that's what we need.
And I'm also the manager for the support crew.
Just going to let the girls know what it is they'll be doing at Mardi Gras. So the support crew this year is going to be doing makeup and costumes for the girls, so they have to learn how to do that. And also they'll be the water girls and checking on any first aid problems as they arise. Hope we don't have any, but you never know.
I just don't think the girls are going to be far enough advanced in their routine for us to really practice a lot of the things that we need to.
Until Monday,
she's been
outside.
Yeah, okay.
Well, here I am again.
Hi, it's Anna Leisa again, and we're about halfway through rehearsals.
And Anna doesn't have a girlfriend. She doesn't have a girlfriend at all. I found that out from, you know, people that know her and stuff.
Not too sure what's going on with Mel, though.
Yeah, I'm really glad I didn't drop out. I'm really glad I stuck with it. It's going to be great. I can't wait to see you. I can't wait to see you. It's going to be fantastic.
I should talk to her. I really should.
Now, Ainsley, I'll tell you the things that I'm covering are the final meeting. We're going to talk about that next 7 o'clock next Monday night at Dante's, just to make sure everyone's available, because that'll be all the Sydney things.
This is finally the last week of rehearsals, week number 3. Feels like we've been out here at the Sports Centre for at least 2 years, and being the team manager has been a great fun at times, and at other times it's just been a lot of stress.
Now, you've got everything organised up out outside or?
I haven't. All I've got is the ute. I've got no idea where the sound system is, how to set it up, anything like that. So someone's going
to let everybody know, we've had a tiny bit of a change. Ainsley and Heidi are going to be up the front permanently now, and as a team.
We haven't made that decision yet.
Yes, we have. No, well, Heidi's still making up her mind. And Sally and Jackie are going to be permanently up the back, okay?
You're on KSRR's Lunchbox 94.9. Joining me in the studio is the very lovely Sally Goldner. Sally, hey there.
I'm a virgin Mardi Gras girl. I've never been as either spectator or participant, yet I've heard through friends that it's just such an amazing buzz.
I think everybody wants to be a Melbourne marching girl.
I can understand that. The marching girls do cover, I know it's cliche, but all ages from 16 to 60 virtually, they're all there. And just is this fabulous show of the diversity of our community.
I sort of jumped into things with a passion. I knew I wanted to be in the Melbourne marching girls. And so I sort of didn't really know why. And once I realised the reason I was here was to just have some darn clean, wholesome, good fun, as that cartoon goes.
Thanks for that, that was great.
Catch up in the shuffle, all right? But don't move the easy walks. They stay on the spot, all right? I'd also like to take this opportunity to thank everybody because you've done a fantastic job. You look really, really great out there in a really short space of time and have been very flexible with changes. So thank you very much. Well done. Okay, let's go, Paul.
Once you started to please, might as well be talking to myself.
For the little listening to me.
Blood is thumping loudly in my
heart.
Monster cast is wrapped around my heart. Might as well be talking to myself.
For the little you're listening to me. Over my plea, I'm talking to myself. A tiny body between laughing and crying, a thin line, living and dying, an even smaller groan in no man's land, no man.
Understood their personal and political power. You know, as a woman, you can make your own choices. You can be yourself. In fact, you have to be yourself to succeed in public life and in private life. If you value yourself as a woman, then other people will value you. Good luck. You can meet the challenge.
Jesus!
come. Cheryl, that's bright. Come here, Chris. Come here.
What are you doing?
Cheryl and I used to work together at school. We used to teach together. But I've now moved on, which is probably a good thing, I think.
We met at the staff notice board.
We did. Marriage made in heaven. And then Michelle immigrated. So we've been through the immigration process, which was the battle with officialdom, and now the birth process. So we're used to things that are a little bit complicated. But that was well worth it, wasn't it? Well, that was a bit.
This is an aside. On March the 2nd, day after Mardi Gras, that's when I'm due to start my next period. So, fingers crossed, if I don't start my period on that day, then maybe I'll be going to the clinic to have a pregnancy test. Who knows? Watch this space.
Cheers.
Hello. Hi, Kerry.
How are you? Have you got an extra ticket to the party?
Yeah, I'd love to go. Yeah, that'd be fantastic. Yeah, I'll be in Sydney on Friday. Okay, I'll give you a call then. Okay, thanks, sweetheart. Okay, see you later. Bye.
Why the hell not?
Well done.
To
the party. Cool.
Okay, I've just got one thing to say. Who the fuck is Kerry?
I'm pretty happy. I'm not pretty happy. I'm actually really, really happy with the way everything's been going so far. I feel a little bit torn and a little bit sad at the minute in that I'm not going to go to Mardi Gras this year. And on one hand, I'd really like to and be with the girls, dance down Oxford Street. And on the other hand, there are other reasons why I'm not going. So, or different personal reasons. This will be the last rehearsal together apart from the full dress rehearsal on Sunday. So I think as a proud mum, I'll have tears in my eyes on Sunday, sort of going, yay girls, good on you and good luck. So that's it, signing off for me, out. See ya. Happy Mardi Gras.
Hello? Yes, Sainsley. We're waiting. No bus, as yet. Yeah, 2:30 the bus is supposed to come in. The bus came in at 4 and it didn't have the items. It was tracked coming in on the 21st. It didn't come on the 21st. It was tracked to come on the 22nd, and here we are. God, they better be there. Hey, a bus! Okay. I got a parcel that should have come on yesterday's coach. I've talked to Brisbane and Marabin, etc., etc. It's probably two parcels for Mary at centrestage.com.
I'm glad you go through all this. I'll be with a parcel and get it a joke. I'll be down late at the freight depot. As soon as I leave here, I'll be about 15 minutes up the road usually.
To Brunswick?
Yes. And you'll see there, I'm
a cheerleader.
Oh, thank
you. For a performance tomorrow for the Melbourne Marching Girls.
So there's none of that club there.
It's not.
Do you mind if we have a bit of a look at the circus stuff?
Could I have a little quick look? Thank you.
That's it.
Oh,
I thought it was that one.
God. Right, I can look forward to tomorrow's performance comfortably now.
Welcoming you to Citizens Park for the Melbourne Marching Girls full dress rehearsal. The excitement is building down here as we take you behind the scenes to meet some of the marching girls themselves. So are you ready for plenty of excitement and lots of marching?
I'm feeling fairly overwhelmed at the moment.
And Ainsley, how are you feeling today?
I'm still very stressed. I'll be happier when it comes 2 o'clock and people start arriving. But I'm really excited about the fact that there's no clouds in the sky and we've hit 25 degrees. So
yes. I'm here with Valmay Todd, a new marching girl. Let's find out how she's feeling today.
A bit nervous. This is getting closer to the real thing. But it's a great day and it's been good coming early and then just unwinding in a social situation.
Fabulous.
I hope I don't fall over or forget the movements.
Right. Okay, but I think you're looking pretty skilled because you've done a bit of dancing before, haven't you?
Yes, I have.
Right, I look laughing. Valmay's laughing. Not a problem.
Hi, my name is Asphyxia and last year I was a Melbourne marching girl. As I'm deaf, I was a bit nervous on the first night as I didn't know how I would socialise with all of the other women involved. But it was really good. We had Linny the interpreter there for me and I was able to socialise with people really well. I was very shy to start with, but after a couple of weeks I was really excited and I chatted to everyone. It was wonderful to have Lynn come to Mardi Gras as well. And it was the first time I've had an interpreter full-time for a weekend. So I was able to really, really connect with people and the women were wonderful and really friendly. I enjoyed it. It was great.
Yep.
Are you
stocking or not stocking? We're stocking. Are we?
Yeah. So it's hot today in Sydney. It's probably going to be a little bit overcast, so it'd probably be on the balance fairly similar.
We're humid though. It'll be sticky humid. So we'll trial them today, the stockings today, and we'll have a vote at the end of the day if we want to keep them.
Can I vote now? So on the hour and a half hour.
Yeah.
Can't you just feel the excitement in the change room? They're all here now, getting their costumes on together as a team for the first time. The Melbourne Marching Girls identify as being lesbian, bisexual, and or transgender. Very open group, very open-hearted group. See, ladies and gentlemen, because the Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras is only 6 days away. They're looking great, but can they last the distance in Sydney where they could be marching for up to 2 hours? So let's wish them all the best. This is Mark Hardon signing off.
Giving one.
Oh, hi, Mum. How are you? Did you get the stuff I sent you in the post?
Yeah, that's the hotel we're staying in. So, you ready to go?
Qantas fly people.
We're not marching girls.
All right.
Yeah, so we're having a peek at your curry.
Come on in.
I hear that you
got kicked out of the pub. King's Cross, you're so noisy.
Yes, we did. And then we got kicked out of a sex bar as well about 5 o'clock this morning.
Would we be able to park our ewes here and do a bit of work on it before we drive into the restaurant?
The best advice I can give you is to do as much work on that vehicle before you enter here. And any last minute stuff you do in the start area, but again, please don't lay anything across emergency access lights.
What time can we get into this start area?
You need to register between 5 and 5:15.
You don't want it filmed?
I reckon he's the one we need to chat to about this.
Earlier, but now I've had a relaxing walk down Oxford Street and I've had a bit of a nana nap, so I'm ready to go.
I'm really getting excited, getting closer and closer all the time now. The inner child is out. I'm taking this.
Ah,
party tickets. Get the party started.
Hi, Doug, it's me. It's confirmed. I know. Thank you, thank you. I can't believe it.
I am with child.
Congratulations.
We're off.
Getting dressed, getting ready, watching the parade actually start and leave the marshalling area, and now they'll well and truly be ready to go. what they'll be doing now is just waiting for a word from a Mardi Gras marshal. I'm sure they're letting them know every 5 minutes just how quickly the parade is running and when the marching girls are about to start. And here they go. You can see the lead float starting to move, which is always an incredibly exciting moment, as it means that the fun is just beginning. Look, there are the Melbourne Marching Boys. What a great send-off for the Marching Girls. The Marching Girls are fabulous and they helped the Marching Girls get started 2 years ago. Well, here they go, turning onto Liverpool Street, which becomes Oxford Street. You can see them really concentrating there. This is the point where you see the crowds either side of you for the first time. You can see the parade in front of you. There's lights in your eyes, there's loud music all around you, screaming people on either side of the road. And it's a really overwhelming moment. This is usually the time where the routine is the messiest, but as they settle down and get underway, the routine will look neater. This is the beginning of Oxford Street. You can see the water girls running there. It's that moment in the routine where they get to run down and hand water out to anyone who needs it. And to tell us about the role of the tech crew, let's hear from Penny McDonald, who was interviewed yesterday.
Tech crew are hot. You've got Jules with her sound, you've got Viv who really has the whole support crew of the girls and the water girls under control. You've got Mary decorating and you've got Liz and Brian who really have been doing this sort of thing for years. And I enjoy my role of being the person who is the one who deals with the Mardi Gras marshals. And the two of us work together so they don't hassle the girls about whether we slowed down or stopped or moved faster. So I think we've got a great tech team and I think we've got to have a great entry in Mardi Gras.
Here they are arriving at Taylor Square, which is the main media area. You can see TV crews coming out to film them there. This is where Australian and international TV coverage happens, and also it's where the judges sit. Every year, the Mardi Gras organisation gives awards to certain parade entrants. The Marching Girls would have been briefed about the importance of Taylor Square, and that's why they're looking very neat at the moment as they come through the area. They know that the images of them in this area basically will go around the world. Isn't it great that Melbourne Marching Girls bring their mothers along? Let's hear a little bit more from Anne Waller.
Hello, I'm Anne. I'm Viv's mum. Wow. I've got a ringside seat sitting in the front of you. Vivian invited me and I thought it was a good idea.
That's all from us, ladies and gentlemen. We'll now leave you with the Melbourne Marching Girls as they journey towards the end of the Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras Parade. Good evening and happy Mardi Gras.
Of course, the Melbourne Marching Girls.
This year they're bad girls and dear ladies. Short skirts, gold dress, devil's horn and moves as the award to the Mardi Gras Parade.
Let's stop the party.
girls, the music. Fantastic.
I'm really proud of myself.
I don't know what to say.
I'm possibly the best night of my life.
She's excited, she's laughing.
I'm about to cry.
I'm getting emotional.
I'm gonna start again because I'm.
So I don't come across as a complete moron at the end in the bleepers, you've just gotta shine the light in my head off you. I was actually.
No, I can't say that.
That's really bad.
That's right.
I've got another product. This is a good one too.
I'm gonna laugh once.
Come back to you.
Cheers to the marching girls.
Fetching new look this year.
Get it between the lines.
I did. Sure. Wonder if anyone will help me take my bra off.
Good job. You didn't mess around, do you? And then the marching girls come along. Oh my goodness.
Let's get this party started.
Hang on, I've got to sort of prep my lines.
Let's get this party started. Bloody
thank you. Go girls, we all like rock and roll.
Yeah.